Okay, this project actually started from my family business. What happened is we are supposed to have a contract with a security, I cannot mention the thing, it's a security thing, where they are transporting important people from one place to another place, and they have to do real-time recording as long as the vehicle is on the move. And as long as the people they are transporting are not back to where they are, the thing has continued running. The vehicle is running 24 volts. And I suspect what happened in the past, when they try to record the thing, they drain the vehicle battery. So when they want to start the vehicle, they cannot. So subsequently, what they did is they requested for 12-volt battery. When they reach the two sites, the thing will run on battery. On the move, because you have alternator running, no problem. So they do not want to risk draining the vehicle battery. They have a contract with us to supply the 12-volt battery for 2 to 3 years, and with a potential extending the contract. But over the last 1-2 years, they have complained we are supplying them defective batteries. What happened is the vehicle is 24 volts, battery is 12 volts because the security system is running on 12 volts. Some wise guys designed this circuit where they run from alternator, step down to 12 volts through a simple rectifier circuit and charging the battery, lead acid battery. Any issue with this circuit? Okay. The issue is lead acid battery, essentially you start with lead oxide and lead. When it's fully discharged, you get lead sulfate on both sides. And the negative plate is your lead, the positive plate is your lead oxide. If you want, I can go into more detail, but let's go through this quickly. Then there's something called the half cell potential. What is a half cell potential? Basically, you are using the hydrogen ion as your reference voltage, and whatever voltage you get the other side, that is your voltage. So with your negative lead itself, you are getting -0.35. On the positive side, the lead oxide, the half cell potential is 1.685. And you add up the two, it's about 2.2. Okay, there are several nasty things about lead acid battery. First thing, it doesn't like to be discharged. It likes to be fully charged all the time. What happens is when you are discharged, you turn to lead sulfate. Lead sulfate is a salt. Salt, when you leave it long enough, it becomes crystal. When it gets into crystal form, you cannot reform the lead sulfate anymore. So your lead acid battery, you leave it too long, your lead sulfate form. If you form the crystal, you find that the capacity will drop. If you keep it charged all the time, which is what they are doing with the space station, they actually keep the battery charged all the time, and they have two sets of battery that they can exercise one set of battery at any time. And lead acid battery, generally, you do not want to bring it below 60%. Because if you bring 60%, some of the top part actually will become not recoverable. Okay, the old ones where you have the liquid, I'm not too sure, in fact, a lot of young ones may not know, you have to keep refilling with distilled water. Why distilled water? Because when you discharge or charge, hydrogen, oxygen comes out. That means you are wasting water. If you top up with the lead acid, you top up with the sulfuric acid, it becomes too concentrated, you're going to destroy the plates. So you have to actually top up with distilled water. And if you put tap water, your chlorine or your chloride will actually again destroy the plates. So what happened with just now the circuit is you don't have a smart charging. So you are pumping voltage and current all the time. And the vehicle may run about 4 or 5 hours. So there's a high tendency for you to overcharge the battery. When you are already full, let's say you eat and you are full, you cannot eat anymore. You try to put in some more food. What is going to happen? There's something negative that happened. Either you come up from up on top or below. Same thing with the lead acid batteries. If it's already full, you cannot charge anymore, but you still insist on pumping in some more. The reverse of charging happens, you become electrolysis. So you're actually going to again pump up the oxygen and hydrogen from the battery. And not only that, you're also going to cause damage to the plates. Plus, you're going to generate a lot of heat. The heat plus hydrogen, oxygen gas. Okay? So it's a very perfect formula for you know what. So exactly what they are doing, they are pumping. Despite the fact the battery is fully charged, they are still pumping. So the battery's life is shortened. So the natural thing is I need to put a proper battery charger, not just a simple charger. Unfortunate thing, I hunt over Singapore. I went to every single shop in Sim Lim Tower. Not a single shop has this combination. They have 12 to 12, 24 to 24. Nobody sells 12 to 24 or 24 to 12. Okay, so without this proper combination, you have a problem because your battery will be either undercharged or overcharged. Either way, it's no good for the battery. So no choice, I had to hunt around and trying to find a proper battery, that means 24 volt to 12 volt battery conversion. Again, I cannot find anything. And while hunting, I accidentally come across something interesting. This solar converter. Okay, the solar converter, basically you cannot predict the voltage. So because you cannot predict the voltage, the solar converters are very lenient. This one actually charges, I think, from 12 to 50 volts. So you have a very wide range where it can charge. So again, you have to proof of concept. That's why I make this thing to do a proof of concept to make sure that it works. And after confirming it works, I have not spoken to the people understanding how they did the charging. So after, I thought it was actually battery to battery charging, which is quite simple. But it turned out that it's actually not battery to battery charging. They are using alternator, transformer, rectifying, and then charging. So you have a problem of pulsating DC. And I'm not too sure what the rectifier they are using. They may be using the wrong rectifiers. So I'm also ignoring that part. I can even literally ignore the transformer. So I can literally take from the alternator because assuming it's a 24 volt alternator, I can have up to about 30 volts is rectified DC coming in. This one can take up to 50 volts, so it's safe. So literally I can take out all the whatever they have done, connect straight to the alternator. I'm putting in my own rectifier. I'm putting in my own capacitor to make sure I get the DC coming in. Theoretically, I don't have to have a flat DC, but I would still prefer a flat DC so that what comes up is more predictable. And I tested. The first thing I get this solar tester, I put in the power in. It did not work. I was fairly angry. I was about to return. And why that happened, I did not have a lead acid battery to test. I just want to ensure this is working, whether to return the thing or not. So I said, to be fair to them, let's put a battery in there. But I didn't have a battery at the time, so I had to wait the next day when I went to office, put on battery. Lo and behold, it works. The solar controller would not work without a battery. So you have no output, you put an input, it will not work. You need a battery there to turn on the circuit. Okay, the other odd thing about China power circuits, normally, we'll switch on the positive side. So when you are trying to switch anything, usually you switch on the positive side and your negative side will be ground reference. You look at most of China chargers, China power products, they are using positive reference, ground switching. Same thing with this one. Lo and behold, Murphy's Law works. During the actual day when I'm demonstrating the person who wants to use, he was quite impressed with the setup, but he has not been demo yet. So on the day I tried to demo it to him, the charging part works perfectly. The power output side, which is this portion here, came on flash. I put a light bulb there to simulate the load. It flashed for a short, about maybe 2 seconds, went off. And when I take out the load, I put it again, it will not flash again. to let it flash again, I have to disconnect all the circuit, connect it back again, put a load, it'll flash again for 2 seconds. And I suspected it, like say, is negative switching. So I left the positive there, put the negative to the battery, works perfectly. But it's actually cheating because I'm actually now tapping straight from the battery. That sort of tell me it's quite likely to be dry joint. So on the spot, I didn't want to do that. Anyway, I just open up the thing, confirm, because the negative side where the switching is done, the lead goes, it's a double-sided board. On the board where the lead came out, it's well soldered. On that, the other side where the component is, you can see that the solder didn't flow through. Most times, the double-sided board, you have actually what they call plate through. This one, apparently, the plate through is not very good. So you do not have a connection from the back plane to the front plane. So just as, again, test of concept, solder both sides. Now it works perfectly. In fact, I didn't bring my light bulb. I can put my that thing there, and anyway, I have to put battery. And, so anyway, now it works perfectly. Okay, the one last thing. The lead acid battery, like I say, wants to be fully charged all the time. How does it do it? First thing is, lead acid battery is generally what they call constant voltage charging. You put in the constant voltage of between 13 to 14 volts to charge the thing. When you are quite near the thing, you actually lower your current. You don't lower the voltage, you can do constant current charging. And when you are very near the peak, if you want to optimally charge your battery, keep your charging current at a very low level, about 100 milliamps. Why you want to do that? Because lead acid battery has a notorious habit of self-discharge. And the self-discharge occurs because there are impurities in the battery. And the impurities actually act as mini cells in the battery that consumes the energy. So lead acid battery, generally, if you are not using for a long time, put it on trickle charge. So all that is done by this little guy here. And this is more or less a setup. I was thinking of whether to bring this or not, so that's a circuit. And this is a block diagram. And this is a... Okay, one funny thing which some... Again, I've not proven this one yet. One of the key battery charging equipment maker suggest a negative pulse every now and then when you're charging. The first time I read that one, I was quite puzzled. Why would you want to purposely put a short negative pulse into the charging circuit? Explanation given is when you're charging, the gases build up. When the gases build up, basically it blocks your charging current. And instead of charging, you're actually creating heat. The negative pulse apparently pushes away the bubbles and we combine the bubbles, so you don't lose as much water. Okay, I think that's about this. Any questions? So, a demo, I have to bring that over, but I need a second source to charge. I can do the power up of this part, but I need a second source, okay? Okay, there's a second part of a demo here. And this one is actually very cool. But this one I cannot bring that because if I bring that, it's going to create too much noise.